Kumar, President, Business Development at Bajaj Auto, is with us. Mr. Ravi Kumar, good morning. You know, exports number is looking good and the market like that. But would it be too early to cheer? What's your take? You know, how's the future looking like as of now?
Number one, of course, in these days, I think from no number we can make a trend looks like. But that said, as far as exports is concerned, what you're seeing is certainly a base effect over last year. So the fact is that at about 115,000 plus minus type of a number for the last 3 months, things are holding at that level. That is good news. It is not falling. And retails are also very much at that level. So in the various markets, whatever we are pushing out is getting well retailed. And that is one point. And the second thing on exports is, you know, we have recently started shipments to Malaysia. So new market expansion is happening. And so I would say I would be neutral. The numbers will hold, I think, at this 115,000 plus minus levels. But this 16% growth that is shown is optics because of the base effect.
Oh, of course. I take that point and the caveat that you are presenting. But you are expecting this 115,000 for how long? I mean, do you see it improving? Because commodity producing countries should be doing a little better, including the likes of Nigeria perhaps. So is this for the first half that you are guiding? For the full year, do you think we can do better than the 115,000?
I think what we'll talk about the next year maybe and the estimates for the next year when we talk again in April with the March numbers. But before that, not hazard, I guess, on those numbers.
Okay, then domestics, Mr. Ravi Kumar, has life returned to normalcy? Are you anywhere near the October levels?
No, not at all. In fact, I think certainly for the two-wheeler industry, the demonetization effect is still panning out. And I think it will take a few more months. If you see even the numbers there, as far as Bajaj is concerned, you know, there are no surprises. We have very well handled this BS3, BF4, BS4 issue. We are supplying to the market only what the market takes, so there is no build-up in the stocks and things like that. But if I just look at some of the competition numbers, I find, for example, Hero just about managing to show a higher retail, slightly more than what it was last year, February, 450, 448 to 450. Similar, I think, HMSI, I find that it's about 120,000 type of a number. But for example, TVS has corrected further. It has gone down to 28. There are two things which are at play, Lata, here. One is certainly what we are seeing is only the wholesale number. On the ground, that may not be the story. People may be building stocks. People may be forced to build stock because of their own position vis-a-vis the BS3, BS4. Some people may not be ready. Some people may be producing more of BS3 in the hope that it will wash out in March. And they have to push into the system, and if they are stuck in that type of a role. So I think from these wholesale numbers, it's very difficult to discern. But I would rather wait for things to normalize. But on the ground, the demonetization impact is still, that bug is still there. It is still not gone.
Okay, you didn't compare your Royal Enfield numbers, Mr. Ravi Kumar. You spoke about some of the other competitors, but they have done
Royal
quite
Enfield,
okay.
No, Royal Enfield is continuing its stellar performance. There is no taking away credit from Royal Enfield. But when what we hear from the market is, of course, we keep tracking the waiting period, the order book, and that is normalizing. So I think it is now in most of the country, it's about a month. It used to be 3-4 months waiting. So we have to really see when that evens out, when it becomes level playing field.
Okay. Your 400cc bike?
But that's it because...
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Good. I was just jumping into that. You also jumped into the same point. Dominar did again a very good number this time, about 3,300 units. And that is being retailed very well. Everywhere it is being received very well. Customers are very, very happy. It's a very nice product at that price point, 400cc cubic capacity. And it's well differentiated. I think it will make its mark very well. We are on course there.
Okay. Mr. Ravi Kumar, you know, so even KTM Duke had the higher cc version being launched. So, you know, I'm not understanding what's happening in this space. Is it just getting out more models? Because the cannibalization is a bit of a risk factor.
I don't think when the brands are so very well differentiated and they stick out so nicely. KTM is ready to race. It is always at the edge. It is Dakar. It is racing. It is race wins. That type of a story. That's a very very clear customer base for that, and I don't think there will be any cannibalization there.
Okay. We're just looking at your monthly charts. If you can get those bar charts yet again. Mr. Ravi Kumar, you all have done month-on-month better since December. You know, 2.25, 2.4, now 2.7. Are your stockists telling you or your retailers telling you that you can at least keep this inching up? I mean, do you get to 2.8 and 2.9 in the coming months? Or even this month itself?
Inching up, certainly. I think we will certainly be looking at that inching up. I mean, month-on-month growth is certainly there. For example, domestic from about 120, we are at 142 in motorcycles. The three-wheeler story is, again, a bit more subdued. I think it is more weightages there a bit more. Mm-hmm. But that said, I think Maharashtra permits are, some of the litigations are all getting sorted out. Mm-hmm. We are hopeful that Maharashtra permits will open up. So I think things will be positive from December. Like you said, things are improving. But, I think we could have done much, much better had this demonetization not hit us.
Oh, yes, we got that loud and clear from Rajiv as well.